Hello and welcome back to American Truck Simulator. Back at it again with the trucking and whatnot, but let's just get right into things as per usual. Oh boy. Nope. We've learned our lesson. You hit M, you go to freight market, and we figure out what's the best available opportunity in the town of Barstow. Barstow to Reading, that's not too bad. 12 grand, it's super speedy, but it's not fragile or high value or anything, so that might not be all that exciting. We don't really have that many other options. Eli, Redding seem to be the two best ones here. Unless you guys just want to make a quick stop in Carlsbad or something dumb like that. But could we check like Prim? Is there anything here? No, that's not worth it. I think we just take some from Barstow. So do we want to go to Eli or Redding? Cheese? We could take some cheese because somebody's got to get cheese. I don't know. Cheese seems nice. Maybe. I don't know. What do we? Why do they need cheese delivered? Maybe the people of Reading really, really, really like cheeses. I don't even. Is cheese grown in California? I can't imagine. Well, I assume it's made most places because all you need is milk and some other additives, but like, I'm not a cheese expert. I've never really been a huge fan of cheese. Like, I'm not gonna show up to your fucking house party and just like eat an entire plate of cheese. It's no good. That's too much cheese. It's like it's got it. Dairy, right? Weird. I'll put up the occasional like cheddar or something, Colby. Something on a sandwich, that's always fine and dandy, but I just can't eat like a fucking wheel of cheese. That's no fun. How long would it take you to eat a wheel of cheese, though? How long does it take the average French person to eat a wheel of cheese? Not that I assume. Do French people eat a lot of cheese? I don't know why in my mind cheese wheels and France are put together. I can't imagine there's any real reason for it. Please? Hello, thank you. All right, Barcelona Reading. Let's crack our back. I wish I could crack my fucking everything like Bruce Lee does, though. Seriously, or did, because he's been dead for like, what? He died in like 1972, 1973. He's been dead a long time. Crazy. But like he just like flexes every muscle in his fucking upper torso and it's just like cracks everything. And like that's just amazing and seems like a very practical skill that I wish I could have. But I am not my own chiropractor. Oh, okay. Hitch it up and get going. All right. But the back to the cheese deal. The deal, what's up with the cheese, guys? What's the deal with that airplane food? What's a good situation for cheese? Like, there's not a whole lot of foods you put cheese in, is it? Like, I don't know, you wouldn't have cheese with fucking dinner. I mean, like, unless you're having like a cheeseburger or something like that, that's probably all right. Pizza's where you find the cheese. All right, so there was this fucking eHow video that's pretty popular because it's so terrible. This chef comes on, is like, "Hello, I'm Chef blah, 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 and I'm gonna teach you how to mix up the cheeses or like prepare the ingredients for a three cheese pizza." And then it's just him like, "All right, so we've got our cheddar cheese, our American cheese." Oh God, I have to sneeze. Excuse me, man. Every time I play this game, I either sneeze, yawn, or cough, and it's the only time I ever do so. Anyway, he comes on, he's like, "All right, we've got our three cheeses here, and they're all in their separate bowl. I'm gonna teach you how to put them all together." And he just literally dumps the bowls, all three bowls, into one single bowl, like, mixes them up with his hand for about 2 seconds, and is like, "There you go. That's how you make three cheese." It's like, what? That was the most cop-out video of all time. Oh, there was the other one. It was like how to draw the pyramids of Giza. Same Ehow stupid shit, but like the guy comes on. We gotta turn on some music. Guy comes on. He's like, get out your architectural ruler, you know, and then we're, and then he's like, make 3 points, and then connect them. It's like, and there you go, there's the pyramids of Giza. It's like, what? It's just a triangle. It was a very nice triangle, I can at least say that much, and I'm sure the cheeses were well matched. Probably would have been very tasty when finally baked onto said pizza. That may or may not have ever been created. You know, I love pizza. Who doesn't? Pizza is such a widely common food. Ah, pizza. The za. I'm pretty sure I've talked about the za before, though. But that cheese thing. Like, what do you do with a wheel of cheese? Does anyone make wheels of cheese anymore? Or is it all packaged into, you know, like, blocks of cheese, bricks of cheese bricks, or, like, shredded, sliced... butt stuff. Was the invention of, like, sliced cheese and shredded cheese invented around this time, like, sliced bread was invented? Because, you know, it's sort of, like, the same process. You have a brick or a wheel or a loaf, and then you cut it. Apparently, it's an amazing invention, though. Nothing as cool as since sliced bread. Hi, Tumbleweeds. I'm so glad I've seen them more a lot. Oh, Tumbleweeds. Oh, I love it. Anyway, has anyone seen or heard of Wonder Bread in a long time? I just wanted to see if there's plenty of rest stops. Holy shit. Because I'm probably going to take a nap coming up here. But has anyone seen Wonder Bread in a long time? For some reason, my brother really liked it when he was younger. And it just... seemed artificial and disgusting. Because it's Wonder Bread, mostly. Alright, let's pull off here and take a nap. And turn off the engine and good night. Guten Nacht. It's not Guten Nacht, that's just a joke. Couldn't find a job and had to return empty. Fuel and maintenance costs are $400. Well, what the fuck, Horst? How do you not find a job? You have a handy-dandy GPS that magically has all the information relevant to you stored right there. Just click the freight market. What are you doing, like going out to fucking flyers and like windows of grocery stores like, hey guys, can I deliver for you? He's gotta go out and fucking like deliver pizza to random homes in his fucking 18-wheeler. That would be hilariously enjoyable to see, though. Some fucking dude just pulls up to your house in a semi-truck and just, like, unloads a pizza from the cab and is like, here you go. And I'm like, oh yeah, that's the way to roll. If they did in, like, a fucking monster truck, that'd be pretty cool as well. I've never been to a monster truck rally, but woo, he's slowing down. Anyway, it seems like something that would be pretty fun, like, unironically. Gotta love the carnal destruction of big cars on other cars. Anyway, I get a lot of advertisements for those, like, Monster Truck Rally in the Metrodome, even though the Metrodome doesn't exist anymore. But they used to be. I wonder if they have been the new U.S. Bank Stadium that's being built. It looks huge from the highway, so that's always exciting. I don't remember what I was talking about. What was I going to talk about? Anyway, about the pizza truck drivers. This one giant fucking storm comes, right? And this was a long time ago. Like, there was a fucking, like, tornado warning and, like, this huge thunderstorm or some shit. I don't know. It was a crazy night. So, like, this fucking lightning strikes this goddamn... Probably, like... 60-foot tall tree, this big oak tree sort of thing just outside my house. It cuts a branch right off. It's a pretty thick branch, and it was happened to be right over the road. It falls, thankfully nobody's parked under it. It falls in the middle of the road. The fucking, like, couple doors down, these neighbors order a goddamn pizza. And they've got It's like, who the fuck? You know, all of a sudden, my brother's, like, watching out the window of the store, and he's like, fuck this, this is enjoyable. And all of a sudden, this, like, Pizza Hut driver shows up and is, like, just parks in front of the fucking fallen log, and is just, like, and it's pouring rain, and it's like, this poor Pizza Hut driver's gotta get out in a fucking tornado warning just to go deliver a pizza for, like, minimum wage. Like, man, that ain't cool. Who needs their fucking pizza? I guess, I mean, that was crazy. That dude was determined to deliver pizza, though. I'm proud of him. But after, like, 10 fucking years, they finally came this fall to cut down the rest of the branch that where it had been split on that tree. That was pretty silly. Took them long enough. I don't even think it was a thread. It was just, like, a tiny bit of branch left. So silly. And they have to block parking for like 2 days. Like, oh, you can't park here from 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Don't you dare. Police. How exciting that is. What a time to be alive. Let's get onto the highway again. Ooh. Oh, don't give me that. I'm going like 35 in a 30. What are you going to do about it? Fight me? 1v1 me, cop. Ossifer. Has anybody, like, called an officer an Ossifer? I assume it has, because otherwise I don't think it'd be a joke, but, like, that seems like something that would happen accidentally. It's just like, you're not trying to make a joke, but then you accidentally call them Ossifer. Does anybody have an ocelot for a pet? That'd be pretty fucking rad, is the thing. Ocelots are interesting creatures. Hello, Mr. Crop Duster. How are you again? Just dusting. Crop dusting. Oh, almost 420 miles left. Hey. Back in, like, high school, we'd play Ultimate Frisbee in, like, the spring just because, you know, whatever. It's Frisbee. We're a bunch of nerds. What other sport do we play? Am I right? Nerds out there who play Frisbee? Yeah, I know what's up. So we go down to, like, the park right after school or some shit and just, like, play Frisbee for an hour or two. And it's like, okay, yeah, it seems pretty rad, except this park was, I think we went down there on April 20th, and it was like everybody was just, like, blazing it off in the woods, and it was like, this is different. At least for me. That was exciting. Although one time we went down there and some dude, like, left us, like, half a pizza. That was exciting. Once again, pizza is pretty fucking delicious. That dude was just, like, there with some lady. He was like, hey, you want a pizza? We're like, oh, yeah, sure, totally. Alright, cruise control at 55 and just let it on a roll. Oh, crack those knuckles. Oh, it's like the one thing I can crack pretty consistently. I love it. Thank God that the whole arthritis from cracking things, I'm a fucking urban legend, because, oh, I wouldn't be alive. My joints are just dandy. My posture, however, is total dog shit. I've been told that when I sit down, I look like my back is broken, because I'm just so hunched forward. It's very awkward. Even now, I should maybe correct this. Make this more enjoyable and a healthy ride. Oh, loan installments. Woo! Ooh, howdy. Ooh, doggy. How far along are we? We still got a little bit of ways to go. Woo! It's like the same thing every day, Binky Boy. Trying to take over the world with my truck. Oh, yeah. Pump it up. I don't know if anybody can hear this, because I've noticed recently that the music seems a little bit quieter than everything else, so I might turn that up a little, see how it works when I go back in. Try to edit it, you know. I just want it to be like a background thing, but who knows. I hate how my fucking microphone resets every time I restart my computer, so, like, there's the occasional episode where, like, my computer just, like, force restarts and, like, resets my microphone volume back up to max, and it just sounds bad. I'm sorry about that. Shit happens. not like I'm gonna go back and record it again, am I right? God, that'd be dumb.
God.
Okay. Well, we're like, what, passing Fresno or something? Right about now? What a California dream. California dreaming. Raining California. It's, Hotel California. I love the fucking Spanish version of Hotel California. Like, well, need to tell California. Oh, it's pretty silly. Sometimes you just gotta nickname places Hotel California, though. It's this sad place where you can check out, but you can never leave. You know that sort of place. We all do. The place you don't want to be, so you just, like, zone out. Oh, can't actually leave, though, because then you might be dead. Oh, well. Whoa. Not much going on today. Just another week in the day of a life of my own anus. So how's your week though? It's pretty nice weather. Daylight savings time is this weekend. Whoa, get excited! Unless you live in the states of Arizona and Hawaii, which in case you don't have daylight savings time, hey, got 'em. Who needs that shit, right? That gets me. Daylight savings time, like, ugh. It's finally bright in the morning again, and bright in the evening. It's all gonna get sorts of fucked up. It's gonna be lighter way later, and what, darker or brighter later as well, I think. Is it? I'm so bad at remembering that shit. I can't remember which way it is. All I know is that I have to reset my clocks. Although, I think there's a couple that do it themselves. That's always pretty nice, and thank God for, like, phones and computer clocks. They do it automatically. And as little effort as I can put into changing time is pretty nice. I love clocks, though. Like, I have, what? If you count my computer and my phone, I've got, like, 4 clocks in this room. In this one room. I love clocks. Gotta get down with some clocks. I just love being able to see the time. You gotta know what time it is. You gotta keep track of time. I'm a careful man. You gotta plan when I how do I use the time. You know? You feel me, Jabra? Bruh. Are we gonna slow down? Yeah, we're slowing down. Damn it. Stockton, why you gotta just not let highways exist? It makes life so much more difficult. Can we do it? Can we make it to a green light? There's one, like, you have to get off the highway somewhere in Minneapolis, and it's like, for all my life that I've been driving there, it's like, there's 3 stoplights. One right off the highway, of course, and then you merge onto an avenue. And then there's one where you go straight, because you can't turn. And then there's another one where I usually turn left, but you can go straight or right. Anyway, I've never in my life been able to make all 3 of those green lights. There's been times where it's close. Like, you gotta get it perfect. It's so difficult. It's gotta be right timing. It never happens. Never happens. One day. Well, do we need gas? I don't know how much gas we have left. But we still have another 240 miles to go. It seems like that's an amount that we might need gas at. Fill me up, buttercup baby. Don't let me down. Let me down and mess me around. But the worst of all, is when you call baby and you say it will. Well, I don't remember the lyrics of that song. I haven't heard it in a long time. I heard a song today, but I don't remember who it's by. It was, like, called Woo, Slow Down for the Red Light. It was not called Woo, Slow Down for the Red Light. I can tell you that much, because that song would be really boring. What song would that be? What kind of genre of music would be would Woah slow down for the red light be? I'm thinking it could be like some sort of gangster rap, like Woah, slow down for the red light. No, the gangster rap would be like the opposite of slowing down for red light. Like, Woah, don't. It'd be like, Woah, don't slow down for the red light, otherwise you might get jumped, or something like that. I don't know. It could be maybe. Maybe it's like a Weird Al Yankovic remix of the gangster rap song "Woah, don't slow down for the red light." That's what I'm thinking. That's that. Of course, first assumes that there would be a song, a gangster rap song for "Woah, don't slow down for the red light," and then it'd be like, "Hey, we're abiding by the law. You better slow down for the red light." Something like that, you know. Except in Weird Al Yankovic's weird voice. I don't know. Where's my album and musicians of the mundanity of like suburban life or something? I'm sure it maybe exists. I gotta pay my taxes. My yearly taxes. I am responsible when drinking alcohol. You know, something like that. Oh, thanks. Oh my god, that guy just wrecked the fuck out of us because he just decided to slow down at the entrance ramp. I like to mow my lawn to keep it in a reasonable appearance for the neighbors. Sometimes I have to deal with stupid problems from the housing association. That'd be great, would it not? That seems like the sort of music the troll Twitter account Moms Against Gaming would be into. That Twitter account, while has certainly slowed down over the last like year and a half, is still, that was pretty funny. And it's prime. It's still going somehow. It's like, I banned Minecraft, yada yada yada. But it was pretty funny. There was the time when it was like, PewDiePie is the worst. Everybody got angry. Oh my god, it was so funny. Just because when you know it's a troll account, but nobody else does. Except a lot of other people. It blew the fuck up. The shadows below the highway ramps here are kind of freaking me out sometimes. Anyway, going back off the music thing, my fucking mother, when I was like 7, bought me a goddamn one of those animal Christmas albums from like the fucking airport one time. It's like, what am I gonna do with Meow Mix Christmas carols, Mom? Jesus Christ, this is terrible. I listened to it like entirely a couple times. I was like, what the fuck is wrong with this? Like, meow, 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 shit like that. It's like, what's the goddamn point? It's fucking weird. It's just the tune. It's a public domain Christmas carols. Whoa. Except with meowing. You hit the fucking jackpot there, Mom. God, what a great gift. Woof, woof, woof. Woof, 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 woof. You could replace it with any sound. You could replace it with fucking, like, cars honking. It'd be just as disgusting. Ah. Shit like that. I don't want that. It could be fucking goose. I'm sure it has some appeal, though. You know, at one point during their prime, I'd wish I had bought a CD from those pan flutists you'd find in the malls, like, all the time. I work for some reason a lot of pan flutists selling all their dope albums. You think they're, like, pan flutists on, like, Times Square in New York City, just selling their pan flute albums? Like, there's the rappers or whatever that I've heard in like Times Square trying to sell you their album. So silly. I assume we have to get gas because we're 162 miles out. We just got the red light. Whoa, my gasoline light just came on, but I was smart and saved a few bucks in my bank account so I could pay for it. I don't know. I don't think that'd be the hit on the album. I think that'd be like lower down. Maybe somewhere in the middle, like number 8 on my disc drops. Album entitled, I don't know what it would be titled. The White Peoplehood, something like that. That'd be interesting. The middle class, middle aged white peoplehood. I'd describe it pretty well. Do you think we're gonna have to stop to check for weight inspection? You know, this cheese might get really heavy. Maybe it's just rotting with fucking, like, tsetse flies in the back. Way station. We don't have to weigh. Hey, congratulations. Please go faster. No, no, yes, yes, no, yes! Maybe you could get somewhere or some, like, other areas? I don't know. No, I think the market for that album is really geared towards the white people. I don't think you could do, like, a rural version. Because that'd just be more lame. That'd just be, like, country music. There's just not, like, a good genre for those middle-aged, middle-class, suburban white folk. What are they gonna listen to? Stuff of their past is usually what it comes down to. You got, like, people listening to stuff what they learned in their youth, what they enjoyed. I'm sure some of it ages, some of it was trends and stuff, but, hey. Who knows? You're gonna be listening to the hits of like, 2010 eventually, right? I don't know. I don't even enjoy this stuff, mostly. Music. Crazy. Just let me listen to my flamenco music, right? Gotta get that Spanish guitar and clapping as your two main instruments. When clapping and hand motions are your main instruments, I think you've got something going for you. If you can pull that off. We haven't seen a gas station in a while. I was gonna stop at the next one, but it's pretty much, we might as well be at the zone. The auto zone. No, the place to drop off the cargo by the time we find a gas station. This could get awkward. I wish I knew how much gas I had left, but as far as I know, there's no distance still empty on this dashboard. Oh, sorry for cutting you off, Mr. RV. There's the little, what's it called? Like, rest stop coming up here. But it's getting real close. I'm gonna start speeding because I need to get to this gas. Where is it? Is it not even here? Where'd it go? Oh god, I'm so sorry. I had to. Oh my god. Highway, make up your mind on where you're going. So I get three lanes. Oh, now it's exiting. No. Now it's merging back together, just for you. The roads gave me a gift, and that gift was my own sadness. I cry, tears of asphalt. That would be painful, wouldn't it? Alright, these cops will never see it coming. Please, we can see it on the mini-map. Get there, one time. Don't run out of gas. We could probably drift into it at this point. I think we've successfully made it to a gas station before we ran out. Oh, high five, everybody. Good work. It was getting real stressful there for a second. I thought I might actually have to do something other than hold W. Not even that anymore, you just hit C and call it a day. Oh my god, is this motherfucker really gonna do this to me? Who is this egg scum in the fucking driver's seat? Mr. Bald-headed guy. Daddy, please move. Hey man. Oh, damn. I was gonna look at his face. I was gonna report him to the police for being a reckless driver. And they'd have to believe me, right? Well, this drive has been going well so far. As well as it can usually go, really. Woo, doggy. Aren't you a pretty lady? I don't even know where that was going. Also, my southern drawl. I don't know why I've been using one multiple times in this video. Never lived in a southern state in my life. I live in a northern state of Minnesota. What am I? Oh, sure. Oh, after this delivery, I'm going to let's go down and get some hot dish. Oh boy, are you fucking with me right now, mate? This is not how you merge onto the highway. This is awkward. At this point, I'd say this might be more than awkward. Please go. Eventually. Okay. Well, this man's never actually gonna get anything done. Because he's absolute horse shit. Please. Now there's somebody behind me. Oh my god, this is dumb. Go, there's no end in sight. Just get out of my way. How are we gonna merge onto the highway like this? I don't know. Mostly, we're gonna get hit by a car, stop the traffic, and just wiggle our way through there, apparently. And that worked out okay. And I stopped the traffic for that guy. Look, I get shit done. It may be in the most brutal fashion possible, but I got shit done, didn't I? Shit did get fucked done. You feel me? Oh, goodness, man. Oh, God. I had to do something there. I had to concentrate. I had to figure a way through traffic. What is this, a game?
You think this is a game?
X is gonna give it to you. Fuck waiting for what you... What? X gonna give it to you. What? Folk waiting for you to get on your own. X gonna deliver it to you. Knock, knock. Open up the door where it's real with the nonstop pop-up and stainless steel. Go hard getting busy with it. I got such a good... And that, once it gets to the verses, I've lost all memorization of X gonna give it to you by renowned rapping legend DMX. One day we'll get to talk about how I feel DMX might be one of the most homophobic rappers out there, mostly in terms of his one song, Where the Hood At, probably one of his more popular songs. He got whatever it's called, like, Up in Here, though y'all gonna make me lose my mind up in here, up in the club, whatever. And then you've got X gonna give it to you, and then you got Where the Hood At. And I'm like, Where the Hood At, it's like, last I heard, y'all N-words were having sex with the same sex. Y'all motherfuckers were having sex, y'all, yeah, whatever. Anyway, it was like, wow, that's quite rude, isn't it? And it's like, even if we squash the beef, I ain't touching your hand, is he crazy? Man, I don't want to talk about it, DMX. But at least he says, I know your style, pussy, because I'm fucking it. So, I mean, he's got shit there. Let's quickly check out if Horse got anything done. That's the bank loan. That's not going to help. We still got 20 days left on our first 100K. Oh, man, it's a tough life for us. Company manager, driver manager? Okay, Horse, okay. You're on duty. You're not... seeming to do anything. Profit per distance, it's worse, it appears, but the profit per day is up. Good job, Horst. Good fucking job. Did you ever level up? Has he done anything? I forgot. I do not realize how the fuck I'm supposed to read these. So this was when he just jacked off in the woods and had nowhere to go, right? And then he must have done a couple missions while we were still driving. So good work. He made a profit. That's something. Good work, Horst. Good work. You're really pulling through for us in the clutch. That's a lie. But, I mean, if you had this guy for your fucking boss, I'd be a little terrified as well. But, thank you for watching this episode of American Truck Simulator. It was a lot of fun, as per usual. And by a lot of fun, I mean it was something to do. So, I still do it for the enjoyment, though, I swear. Anyway, I'll see you next time.